Hi friends, in this video we are discussing vector differentiation. Okay, vector differentiation. In the previous video we already discussed what type of the topics we have in a vectors calculus. That is, first one is vector differentiation, second one is vector integration. So in this video we are discussing vector differentiation. Okay, differentiation, if you want to do, for what we will apply differentiation, means is it a constant or else a function? Means it is a function. So for the function we will do the vector differentiation. You see, what type of the function? Means point function. In this vectors we will do the differentiation for the point functions. Point functions are how many? Means two types we have. One is a scalar point function, another one is vector point function. First one we will discuss what is the point function. Later on what is the scalar point function and a vector point function we will discuss. First of all, point function means a variable quantity whose value at any point in the region of the space depends upon the position of the point is called a point function. Okay, these are how many types? Means two types. Position of the point in the region space depends upon the position of the point is called a point function. Okay, now these point functions are two types. One is vector point function and the one is scalar point function. Scalar point function means consider a region in a three-dimensional space. In a region in three-dimensional space, to each point P of x, comma, y, comma, z. Suppose we associate a unique real number, say phi of phi. This is in the form of phi of x, comma, y, comma, z. Of course, some other will say phi of x, comma, y, comma, z is called a scalar point function in the region. See, we consider in a three-dimensional space. Three-dimensional space. That is why you have P of x comma y comma z. If it is in two-dimensional space, then simply we will start with P of x comma y only. We associate a unique real number, say phi or phi of x comma y, is called a scalar point function on the region, given region, two-dimensional. If it is in three-dimensional, phi of x comma y comma z is called a scalar point function. In two-dimensional, phi of x comma y is called a scalar point function. Okay, for example, you can say phi of x comma y comma z is equal to 2x plus 2y plus 2z. Is there any vector? No. So simply 2 times of x plus y plus z. One more example, phi of x comma y comma z is equal to x square y z in 3 dimensional. Suppose you can also say that f is equal to x plus y plus 2. Is there any judgments? No. So phi of x, f of x comma y or phi of x comma y is equal to x plus xy plus 2. This is, you can also denote with f of x comma y. This is also scalar point function only. Is there any z term here? No. That is why this is 2. Okay. That is why it is in two dimensional space. Right. Next, general example I will give. Take a heated solid. At each point of P of x comma y, either here, whatever it may be, each point of P of x comma y of a solid is, there will be a temperature. The temperature is, we are denoting with T of x comma y. So this is called a scalar point function. This is called a scalar point function. I will repeat again. Take any heated solid. At each point, every point, there will be exist one function. That function is having some temperature. There exists at each point, there will be some temperature. The temperature we are denoting with T of x comma y comma z. So this is example for the scalar point function. Now coming to the vector point function. Vector point function is, if to each point P of x comma y comma z we associate a unique vector f bar of x comma y comma z. Here you see unique real number means P of x comma y comma z. Here unique vector means f bar of x comma y comma z. If there is no bar, then that is called a general function, that is scalar point function. If bar is there, so simply we are denoting, if you want to say this is a vector, bar, with bar we are denoting f bar of x comma y comma z. This f bar of x comma y comma z is called a vector point function. For example, what you can say means generally acceleration. Okay, suppose for example the velocity of a moving fluid and gravitational force are examples for the vector point function. That's it. So this is about the scalar point function and vector point function examples.